Welcome to Towns County High School for the second day of the Battle of the States Christmas Tournament. The current lineup will be the Hokes Bluff Lady Eagles versus the Union County Panthers. Hokes Bluff will be the visiting team. Union County will be the home team. And now for the starting lineup for the Lady Eagles. Number 14, Sydney Ball. Number 15, Amanda Noah. Number 24, Logan Black. Number 25, Tylen Register. And number 42, Kendall Johnson. The Lady Eagles are coached by Jason Schill. And now the starting lineup for the Union County Panthers. Number 4, Bailey Daniel. Number 10, Adeline Dockery. Number 11, Maggie Beth Stewart. Number 15, Ashley Fair. And number 20, Grace Wishmer. The Panthers are coached by David Tucker.
Good afternoon and welcome to Towns County High School 23rd Annual Battle of the States Tournament. First semifinal of the day, Hokes Bluff Lady Eagles, Union County Lady Panthers. Union County will move from left to right on your television screens. Hokes Bluff from right to left. Hokes Bluff wins the tip and we are underway. And again, the first semifinal of the day, Logan Black brings it across half court against Union County's 2-3 zone. Head coach David Tucker for Union County. Been at Union County for a number of years. He employs this 2-3 every time. Shot up and no good for Kendall Johnson of Hokes Bluff. And Union County will have their first possession of the contest. Hokes Bluff 59-25 winners in the first game of the Battle of the States tournament this year over Lumpkin County yesterday. A game where the Lady Eagles outscored the Lady Indians 18-1. In the fourth quarter of play to really seal that game. Union County has possession on the court. We're still scoreless as Bailey Daniel drives to the right side and kicks it out to Grace Wishmeyer. Now down inside, this is Adeline Dockery who puts it up, no good. Kendall Johnson will pull down the rebound and Hokes Bluff will try and slow down the pace. Hokes Bluff likes to take their time and make their opponents play in the half court as much as possible defensively. Johnson up, no good. Rebound to Grace Wishmeyer. Union County on the opposite end will look to play half court, but they'll also try and get out in transition if they can. Shot up by Dockery is good, and that's the first 2 points of the game. Hokes Bluff against the full court pressure. This is Amanda Noah who will draw the foul. Foul go on Bailey Daniel, her first. First team foul. As Hokes Bluff looks to inbound right below us. Now Sydney Ball gives way to Logan Black and it's taken away. Good defensive effort there from Bailey Daniel to read the pass. She'll walk it up half court and look to set the play. Coming off the screen from Dockery, kicking out and a three-pointer on the way from Ashley Fair is short. And Amanda Noah will pull down the rebound. Jason Shields, the head coach of the Lady Eagles of Hokes Bluff from Alabama, that's Logan Black who turns the ball over. Trying to get it to Tylen Register. The winner of this game will play in the finals tomorrow at 7 p.m. against the winner of what is sure to be a good matchup between Hayesville and Towns County. Hokes Bluff with possession. This is Logan Black swinging the ball around. Now Tylen Register going to drive in. Had some space, but it was batted away from behind as the Panthers will make a few substitutions. Among them, Brooke Dockery, the freshman guard for Coach David Tucker. Also, number 14, Andalyn Hill, another freshman. Amanda Noah pumps, drives, puts up the floater, and left it short. Rebound comes down to Brooke Dockery, and she'll dribble out of pressure to allow Union County to set up. Still 2-0 here in Hiawassee. 23rd annual Battle of the States tournament. Brooke Dockery goes around and turns the ball over. Good defense there from Logan Black. Now Amanda Noah up the floor. She put the ball on her hip and took too many steps. Hokes Bluff bringing a very good crowd over from Alabama. Union County, of course, bringing their contingent over to Towns County. Here's Bailey Daniel drawing the foul. They're going to give the foul to Logan Black, her first. Union County inbounding. Good play there for Brooke Dockery, but then she tried to put the ball on the floor between three green jerseys. Up the floor quickly now. Amanda Noah finds Register, looking down low for Kendall Johnson, but they will go away from her momentarily. Now down low to her. Nice move underneath. She missed the layup, though, and it comes out to Andalyn Hill. Hill finds Brooke Dockery, and she will bring it up the floor. The freshman comes off a screen into the lane, kicks out, and Ashley Fair, the senior, misses a three. Rebound loose, and it will go the other way to Hokes Bluff. Gracie West checking into the contest, finished yesterday with 8 points against the Lady Indians of Lumpkin County. Amanda Noah gets the pass, but then overthrows Gracie West and can't make the save. Union County with their full court pressure, able to get the turnover. Still 2-0. We're nearly halfway through this first quarter of play. As Andalyn Hill gives way to Kate McCarter, a lot of freshmen going to play for Coach David Tucker. Stolen away this time, and Sydney Ball's going to go up and in for 2 points. That's going to trigger David Tucker to make a move to his bench and get Megan Bright up and ready to go, it looks like. Brooke Dockery going to drive down the right side, put it up, no good. Pulled down by Gracie West. West trying to find somebody to throw it to and finally gets it up the floor to Kelsey Otwell. Now Sydney Ball pulls it back out and gives to Gracie West and then gets it back. High post, Amanda Noah lost the handle. It comes out to West and the ball's now loose on the ground. A jump ball. Possession will stay with the Lady Eagles. It's actually Jordan Rogers who is at the table ready to check in for Union County. Tylen Register will inbound below the basket. Nice pass inside to Amanda Noah, blocked though by McCarter, and then stolen away by Jordan Rogers. Brooke Dockery brings it across half court. One of five freshmen on this team, three of which are on the floor right now. Looking for a white jersey, she finds her fellow freshman Andalyn Hill, who gives it to Ashley Fair. Now down low, Kate McCarter puts it up and in. The freshman post has two of the 4 points on the board for the Lady Panthers. Now Register going to drive in. Almost took too many steps, but then she pulls it back out. Register looking down low. That's Otwell. Gives it to Noah. Now to Sydney Ball. Skip pass, and they look down low for Otwell. Nice bounce pass underneath, and she's fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. They're going to call the foul on McCarter, her first. First free throw on its way is good for Kelsey Otwell. Logan Black able to check back in. K. Kendall Johnson getting set to check back in. Second free throw is up and good. Otwell was not in the scoring column yesterday. She has two today. Kendall Johnson will replace her with 2:21 to play in the quarter. Full court pressure this time by the Lady Eagles. Panthers break the pressure. This is Jordan Rogers. One dribble in, gives it to the post McCarter, and she missed the layup. Now Register off of a screen, driving, puts it up through contact, and it's out of bounds off of the Lady Eagles. Coach Shields is saying that had to have been tipped if you're not going to call a foul, but I believe that the officials on the floor made the right call. Bailey Daniel will check in and inbound the basketball to Brooke Dockery. This is the first of four semifinals coming up. Number four, Bailey Daniel fires a three. It's no good. Offensive rebound, though, for the Lady Panthers. In Kate McCarter, she's got four. Lumpkin County's boys getting set to take on Swain County after this one, and then Hayesville and Towns go doubleheader action. Out of bounds, it'll stay on this end of the floor. Six-four, your score. Inside and tipped out of bounds by Tylen Register, and it'll be Lady Panther basketball as Grace Wishmeyer checks back in. Two seniors on the Union County squad, Ashley Fair and Brittany Thornton. Three juniors, four sophomores, and five freshmen. Here's one of the juniors in Bailey Daniel looking down low. And then kicking back out to reset. Union County loves to move the ball against the 2-3 zone. Try and get as much ball movement as possible and never let the ball get stale. It's out of bounds. It'll stay on this end of the floor, and Ashley Fair will inbound. Three-pointer on the way from Bailey Daniel off back iron, and then pulling down and traveling, as she kind of got hit by her own player there, was Sydney Ball. Inbound and trying to get it back in, it was Jordan Rogers. She steals the ball back from Register. Now a three from Daniels, no good, and a rebound to Sydney Ball. The winner of this game will play at 7 o'clock against the winner of Hayesville and Towns a little bit later on tonight. The loser will play at 4 o'clock tomorrow against the loser of that Hayesville and Towns County game. Of course, this game was supposed to tip off at four. A couple of overtime games earlier on as the foul comes on Union County. Give that to Ashley Fair, and she'll take a break as Adeline Dockery checks in. 36 seconds to play in the quarter. Gracie West gives to Tylen Register, 2-3 zone again for Union County. Register looks into the corner and finds Sydney Ball. Ball skip pass over to Black, kick out to West, still running some clock. Now a wide open three for Logan Black was no good. Rebound tipped out. Hokes Bluff comes away with it with 10. Swung around the horn. Gracie West with five. Gets it back out to Logan Black. A couple dribbles, kicks it over. Gracie West needs to get a shot off, and Hokes Bluff won't get the shot off before the end of the first quarter. Your score after one. Union County 6, Hokes Bluff 4. Back in a moment. back here at the 23rd annual Battle of the States Christmas Tournament from Towns County High School. 6-4 your score. Union County leads Hokes Bluff. Two overtime games earlier in the girls' bracket. Lumpkin County comes back from behind to beat Swain County, the newcomers to the tournament. Swain County led for most of that matchup and then led early on in the overtime period by four, a quick 4-0 run by the Maroon Devils before Lumpkin County finished the overtime period on a 10-0 run to advance to the fifth-place game. And then the Polk-Piedmont game, as a carrying violation was called on Union County's Bailey Daniel. Polk and Piedmont came down to an overtime finish as well. Polk County trailing for most of that game as Hokes Bluff finally gets the shot up from Kendall Johnson. It'll stay on this end of the floor. Polk County trailed for most of that game, hit a layup with 2.6 seconds to play in overtime. Piedmont had a great look at a layup as that's Sydney Ball hitting the three-pointer to give Hokes Bluff their first lead of the game at 7-6. Piedmont had a wide open layup as time expired and missed it. So Polk County will play Lumpkin at 1 o'clock tomorrow for fifth place as we see Adeline Dockery knock down her third and fourth points and retake the lead for the Lady Panthers. Top of the key now, this is Sydney Ball, who gives to Amanda Noah, looking down low for Johnson. That's the game plan. Skip pass over, and now Ball gets it back, finds Noah at the high post down low. Great ball movement to get it to Kendall Johnson for her first two of the game. The boys' side of the tournament today is we see Adeline Dockery knock down 5, 6, and 7. Now 11-9 with 6.5 to play in the half. Union County pulls away late to defeat Hokes Bluff in the first consolation boys game of the day. And then Polk County hits a shot late and then draws a late charge as time expires to beat Piedmont in the game right before this. As Union County will pretty much do a wholesale substitution here. Four new players on the floor, joining Bailey Daniel. Inbounding to Logan Black. Logan hands off to Amanda Noah and gets it back. Skip pass over. Now driving is Tylen Register. She lost her footing, but they're going to call a foul on Brooke Dockery, her first. 4th team foul on the Lady Panthers. Amanda Noah gives it to Register. Register looking back, finds Sydney Ball trying to get it inside to Amanda Noah. A jump ball going to be called. Hokes Bluff will retain possession on the alternating arrow. Inbound to Sydney Ball, and then it's swung around to Kendall Johnson, who puts it home. She'll go to the line to shoot one. This ties the game up. The foul going to be given to one Kate McCarter, her second. Hokes Bluff, the defending champions of the Battle of the States tournament, as Johnson misses. It got the rebounded Union County, and it's swung around, and now Dockery will bring it up the floor. Hokes Bluff defeated Hayesville in the championship last year to claim their first Battle of the States tournament as the three-pointers missed by Union County. They move the ball quickly up the floor. Register. 2-on-1, but the bounce pass to Amanda Noah went haywire, and we're still knotted at 11 as there's a substitution that's going to come in the game. Gracie West checks in. And Union County will bring it across. Both champions from last year are in this tournament. Lumpkin County still looking to defend. They will play in our next semifinal against Swain County. Three-pointer on the way is no good for Union County. Amanda Noah is going to pull it down. And Hokes Bluff looking to slow the game down. Finds Noah in the middle of the floor. Does Sydney Ball now driving. One dribble for Johnson's no good. Tipped out to Sydney Ball. David Tucker wants that long rebound to be able to get in transition. Amanda Noah, couple dribbles, gives way to Logan Black. Now inside Sydney Ball, puts it up, left it short. It was partially blocked there by Brooke Dockery. Jump ball possession will go to Union County, and that'll bring Kelsey Otwell back into the game. Dockery will bring the ball up the near side of the floor. Nobody picks her up, so she'll take it all the way to the hoop. She missed the shot, and Hokes Bluff comes away with the rebound with Sydney Ball and now Gracie West. Ball skip pass to Logan Black. David Tucker not happy with the defensive pressure or lack thereof as Black gets it out to West. West guarded very closely by Ashley Flair, or Fair rather. An A-wire, or an awkward shot rather, from Gracie West. And now Union County picked up the dribble there, did Brooke Dockery, but Adeline Dockery is going to fire a three. It's no good. Gracie West pulls down the rebound. Almost tied up, but West pulled it away strongly from Ashley Fair. Hokes Bluff again looking to slow this game down. They like a low-scoring game unless they can get out in transition. 11-11. Nice cut from Gracie West, and she couldn't catch the ball but ended up coming up with it before it went out of bounds. Again, a near wholesale substitution coming for Union County. The next whistle, and there's the whistle as Gracie West will get to go to the free throw line to shoot two. Union's sixth personal foul. That foul is going to go on Andalyn Hill, her first, the freshman. Gracie West's first free throw is good. Her first point of the contest. Sophomore Gracie West at the line. She's given Hokes Bluff the lead at 12-11. Here's the second. She missed that one, but an offensive rebound by Kelsey Otwell, a jump ball, and Hokes Bluff will again get possession. Inbounding is Logan Black. She gets it to West. West missed the shot. Otwell with the offensive board, and Hokes Bluff will be very happy to take some more time off the clock. West driving in the middle of the lane. Beautiful pass underneath. Not being able to handle it was Ball. And so they reset. Driving in now is Register. She puts it up through contact and in. Tylen Register with her first two of the contest. 14-11 with about 2:15 to play in the first half. Almost taking too many steps there was Jordan Rogers as the skip pass goes over to Ashley Fair. Now a three-pointer coming from Bailey Daniel. It's off the back of the iron. No good. Offensive rebound for Union County. And number 20, Grace Wischmeyer, gets her first 2 points of the contest. 14-13. This is exactly what we expect from a semifinal with two teams that love to play defense. Now underneath is Otwell. She kicks it out to Sydney Ball. Swung around the horn to Tylen Register, who puts it up, no good. Rebound goes out to the senior, Ashley Fair. Daniel trying to split the press on her own, and it'll be Fair drawing a foul from Hokes Bluff. Just the second personal of the half for Hokes Bluff. They're going to give it to Sydney Ball, her first. Inbounding on the far end, Union County, and Bailey Daniel will set the offense with Brooke Dockery. Two-guard front for Union County, man-to-man for Hokes Bluff, and it was Andalyn Hill who could not handle the hot pass there from Dockery. Inbound and up the floor now, and a foul called. It'll be a one-and-one opportunity for Logan Black as David Tucker, visibly unhappy, on the sideline. Foul goes on Bailey Daniel. One and one opportunity. Logan Black's first free throw up and good. Extends it to a 2-point lead, 15-13 in favor of the Lady Eagles. Second free throw is up as well. Off back iron, Union County can tie or take the lead with a three. Nice move getting to the basket there from Bailey Daniel. Her first 2 points of the game. She spun and got through the defense by herself, put it in, knotted up at 15 apiece. Under 50 seconds to play in the half, swung around. This is Amanda Noah, who lost the handle and took too many steps at 44.2 to play. Hokes Bluff going to go into a full court pressure, try and slow Union County down a little bit. Brooke Dockery gets it across easily, and now Bailey Daniel has it. Daniel gives it up top to Andalyn Hill, then gets it back. 30 seconds to play. A three-pointer is up, no good. Offensive rebound, though, for Union County. Daniel's going to fire another three. That one's no good, and this time Johnson's able to pull it down. She turns it over. Shot no good from Jordan Rogers. It goes out of bounds. Hokes Bluff basketball. 14 seconds to play in this first half of play. We're tied at 15. Number 15, Amanda Noah pulls it down, gives it to Sydney Ball. Now Tylen Register gives to Noah. 7 seconds to play. Noah drives, puts it up. No good. It goes out of bounds and will go to Union County. Jason Shields this time not happy, as he thought that a white jersey touched it last. Just under 5 seconds to play here. There's the inbound. It's Dockery. Dockery gives it up, and that will be how the first half ends. 15-15. We've got a good one in the first semifinal of the day. You're watching the 23rd annual Battle of the States Christmas Tournament. Union County and Hokes Bluff knotted at 15 as we head to halftime. Back with you here at the 23rd Annual Battle of the States Christmas Tournament. 15-15 your score as Union County will have possession to start the second half of play. Moving from right to left, a quick three-pointer by Bailey Daniel will go out of bounds, and it will be Lady Eagle basketball. Sydney Ball led the way for the Lady Eagles, 5 points. Kendall Johnson with four, and then four other players with either 1 or 2 points. For the Lady Panthers, it was Adeline Dockery, who was the leading scorer, 7 points. Kate McCarter had four, but give 2 more points to Kendall Johnson, who retakes the lead for Hokes Bluff. We knew it was going to be a very defensive game. Both teams liking to play defense. Union County trying to get out, likes to get out in transition and use their offense that way. Hokes Bluff loving to play half-court offense and slow this game down. Bailey Daniel lost it out of bounds off of Amanda Noah. It'll still be Lady Panther basketball. And Bailey Daniel lost her footing and goes out of bounds. It'll be Andalyn Hill to check in. And a foul called on Bailey Daniel, her third personal. David Tucker going to keep her in the game, though. As that ball will be out of bounds, Hokes Bluff basketball. Swung around the horn. Noah gives to register, then gets it back. Noah, one dribble to register, then Noah gets it back again. They're trying to get it inside to Kendall Johnson. It's very apparent, and they do get it inside to her. She'll go up and be fouled as she shoots to the line to shoot two. The foul will go on Adeline Dockery, her first. Free throws coming for Kendall Johnson. First one on the way is good. Seven points now for Kendall Johnson. Missed the free throw, did the senior. And Union County comes down with the rebound. And then turns it right back over to Hokes Bluff. Black and Ball working it around, and now register, thought about a three-pointer, drives in, good effort getting to the basket, but could not put it home. Amanda Noah, I thought she stepped out of bounds, but a timeout going to be called before Noah throws it away. David Tucker does not like it. 30-second timeout going to be called by Hokes Bluff, and was a little bit questionable as if Jason Shields got the timeout called in time. They say that he did, just barely. Noah was falling out of bounds and tried to throw it, but apparently the timeout was called just before she let go of the basketball. David Tucker not happy that Hokes Bluff's going to retain possession here. And now the fans are going to make sure their voices are heard. A across half court. Now comes Union County. Here's Adeline Dockery driving, putting it up and in. Dockery continues to lead the Lady Panthers. She has 9 points. It's still a one-point game in favor of Hokes Bluff. We're in the third period here at the Battle of the States Christmas Tournament. 23rd annual one hosted by Towns County. Up no good by Amanda Noah. She gets her own rebound, kicks it out. Three-pointer on the way. Tylen Register able to get 3, 4, and 5 on the board. Now, Union County, Bailey Daniels, she's going to try and answer. No good. And Hokes Bluff pulls it down, and look at how they just back it up and hold it in the backcourt to be able to milk some time and play Hokes Bluff brand of basketball. Skip pass over, pump fake, driving in is Register. Bounce pass a little low for Johnson, but the Lady Eagles still come up with it. Again, Hokes Bluff, the defending champions of the Battle of the States tournament. And it comes from playing basketball like this, slowing it down. Register, down low to Johnson. Johnson couldn't handle the pass. And Union County will come up with it with Brooke Dockery. Skip pass over and around. Bailey Daniel gives to Ashley Fair, who missed the three. Union County has had trouble behind the arc tonight. Sydney Ball, cross half court, tries to find Tylen Register and does. Register bounce pass to Johnson, looking outside. Now Sydney Ball going to pop a three. It's good. And that'll trigger a timeout from Hokes Bluff to set the defense here, leading by 7. It's a full timeout. We'll take it with him. 4:11 to play in the third. Your score, Hokes Bluff 24, Union County 17. Back in a moment. .411 to play, third period. Hokes Bluff stretching their lead out to 7 points, largest lead for either team in this one, as they will try and advance to the championship game again. For the second consecutive year. Newcomers to the tournament last year, Hokes Bluff was. And they win the tournament in decisive fashion, running away from Hayesville in the championship game. They have the ball here, up 7 against Union County. Now Johnson underneath. She puts it up, no good. Rebound to Jordan Rogers. Three teams from Georgia in this one, Lumpkin, Union, and Towns, as Union gets it down low. This is McCarter missing. Offensive rebound for Jordan Rogers, who finds her first two of the contest. Three from Georgia, two from Alabama, Piedmont and Hokes Bluff, two from North Carolina, Swain County, the newcomers, and Hayesville, and then Polk County from Tennessee, a true battle of the states, with four states being represented in this one. Johnson bounce pass out to Register, who had some miscommunication, but it comes up with Logan Black, who's able to keep it in the front court. Down low, Johnson, one dribble, puts up the hook shot and was fouled on the way up. She'll go to the line to shoot two. The foul will go on McCarter. That's her third. Third team foul on Union County. And Johnson to the free throw line to shoot two. She's already got 7 points on the day. She misses the first as the Lady Panthers will get a few subs into the game, including Adeline Dockery, who leads all scorers with 9 points. Union County really going to have to get Adeline going. Second one on the way is no good. A defensive rebound, as it was Kate McCarter coming down somehow with it and then tiptoeing the line, keeping a pivot foot. Now Wishmeyer gives it up top to Bailey Daniel, inside to Dockery, who lost the handle. Hokes Bluff bringing it up the floor quickly with Register, and now they slow it down. Almost getting the steal there was Ashley Fair. The shot's no good, and it will go to Union County off the defensive rebound. Shut up. 30-second timeout going to be called by Union County. 2:22 to play in the third as Coach David Tucker wants to talk this through. It was 15-15 at halftime. A 9-4 run by the Lady Eagles to jump out to a 7-point lead, now a 5-point lead for the Lady Eagles of Hokes Bluff. Hayesville and Towns County a little bit later tonight, doubleheader action in the third and fourth semifinals. The second semifinal will be Lumpkin County and Swain County in what should be a pretty decent game. The defending champions will take on the newcomers to the tournament. That pass taken away by Register. She'll drive in, put it up, and in for two as Tylen Register has 7. Takes the lead back out to 7 at 26-19. And then Union County throws it right away. And Hokes Bluff again with an opportunity to extend this lead. Winner will take on the winner of Hayesville and Towns County tomorrow at 7. Loser will play tomorrow at 4 against the loser of Hayesville and Towns. Hokes Bluff working it inside. Nice pass, Tylen Register. She goes up, missed it, but an offensive rebound. Kendall Johnson, who's able to put it home with 9 points now for the senior center. Hokes Bluff in full court pressure now, trying to force Union County to get antsy in the backcourt. Shots no good by Ashley Fair. Ashley has had a tough go at it today. She's missed a number of threes and just missed that elbow jumper. Now Sydney Ball across half court. She'll skip it over to Logan Black and then get it back. Register down low to Johnson. Johnson kicks out. Three-pointer on the way. Logan Black is short. Rebound will come out to Adeline Dockery. And now Union County looking to get the ball up the floor before the defense can get set. Skip pass over a little high for Bailey Daniel. She gets it, though, and here's a three-pointer coming from Brooke Dockery. It's no good. Union County has not made a three, to my knowledge, tonight, or to my recollection. Sydney Ball content to hold it out. 33 seconds now. Nice pass inside to Kendall Johnson, who's got 11. She'll go to the line to try and get number 12. As Union County again commits a foul, this one by Kate MacArthur. That's number 4 on the freshman post. Jordan Rogers going to check in for Dockery. MacArthur's still in there for Coach David Tucker. Here's the free throw from Johnson off the iron. No good. It comes out to Union County, and then it's almost thrown away. It'll go off of Sydney Ball out of bounds, and Coach Jason Shields saying back up to half court, and let's get some pressure on. 28.2 left in the period. 11-point lead for the defending champion Hokes Bluff Lady Eagles. And a double dribble there by Brooke Dockery. 22 seconds to play now. Register comes across half court, picks up her dribble, gives it to Sydney Ball. Now back to Register. Looking inside for Johnson with 10 seconds now. Noah gets it inside to Johnson. Bounce pass to Register. One dribble. Puts it off the glass. No good. And a rebound comes out to Ashley Fair and Union County. Not aware of the time left on the clock, they're not going to get a shot off. And that's how the third quarter will end. A big run by the Lady Eagles in the third period of play. In fact, a 15-4 run in the quarter. Your score, 30-19. Hokes Bluff leads it. We'll be back in just a moment. Hokes Bluff will get the basketball to start the fourth and final quarter of play, leading by 11. They outscore the Lady Panthers 15-4 in the third quarter of play. And it's come by playing their brand of basketball. Slow it down, get it inside, and then just make a layup. Now Ball, she'll make the layup as she gets it inside. 32-19, and then it's turnover. Tylen Register leading the three-on-one break. She'll give it to Amanda Noah, who had it blocked by Grace Wischmeyer. Wischmeyer dribbling outside. She picked up her dribble. Amanda Noah steals it away. Noah 1-on-0. She'll lay it up and in. And a whistle, a timeout, I believe, is going to be called by Union County. Seconds for David Tucker with 7:14 left and a quick 4-0 run off the top of the fourth period for Hokes Bluff. A very impressive start to this second half for Hokes Bluff in this one. Inbounding now for Union County. Andalyn Hill, she gets it back from Bailey Daniel, and then Hill tied up. She somehow gets it out of the trap and skips it over to Kate McCarter. Bounce pass down low to Hill. Now Daniel gets it back, looking down low for McCarter. McCarter up and no good. Offensive rebound blocked by Ball, but then Jordan Rogers ends up putting it home on the second opportunity. 34-21 now. Register gets it across half court. Picked up or dribbled, though. And the pass was errant. And Ashley Fair comes away with it. Three-pointer on the way for Bailey Daniel is no good. Rebound to Amanda Noah. And then the Lady Eagles are going to push it across half court with Logan Black. Kick out to Register. Register wisely turned away from the contested three. Down low now to Johnson. Kick out, and a three-pointer coming from Logan Black is short. Rebound tipped up, and Sydney Ball somehow comes up with it. But then Union County steals it away as Jason Shields yells to get back. Gingerly running down the floor there with Sydney Ball. She ends up getting the steal. A sub's coming for her with Gracie West, I imagine. And stepping out of bounds was Union County touching the ball. Gracie West is going to check in. and replace Amanda Noah, actually. Union County is going to get Brooke Dockery back into the game. Hokes Bluff will counter with another sub in Kelsey Otwell. 13-point game, 5:45 to play. This is when Hokes Bluff did their damage yesterday against Lumpkin County in the second half. This time Otwell turns it over. Outscored the Lady Indians 32-11 in the second half. Three-pointer on the way is no good. Rebound pulled down by Register. Register's going to lead the two-on-one break, but then pull it out as she realized what the clock said and what the scoreboard says. Three-pointer coming from Sydney Balls. No good. Rebound to McCarter. Union County gets it to their point guard and Brooke Dockery. Dockery gives way. Three-pointer from Andelin Hill. No good. Rebound tipped up and out of bounds off of Hokes Bluff. Lady Eagle basketball. Inbounding to Andelin Hill now. And then Brooke Dockery in between the circles. Dockery's pass was almost batted away there from Logan Black. Now down low, batted out of there was Kelsey Otwell. The pass was intended for Jordan Rogers, but like any good linebacker on a slant pattern, she just batted that ball away. And then a foul going to be called this time as I believe that was Brooke Dockery driving in. The foul is going to be given to Tylen Register, her first, just the first team foul of the half for Hokes Bluff. Here comes the inbound for Union County. And it's stolen away by Logan Black. Logan almost had it taken away from her. She gets it back to Sydney Ball, who gets it up to Tylen Register to break the pressure. Hokes Bluff has done a great job of breaking pressure all game. Now the bounce pass through to Sydney Ball, over to Register, who will fire a three. It's online, and it's good. Hit the bottom of the net, 10 points for Tylen Register. The senior forward for Hokes Bluff hitting a three that puts the Lady Eagles up 16 as the three-pointer for Union County is off the mark. Rebound comes out to the shooter in Ashley Fair. Ashley has had a real tough go at it today. And now a jump ball. Possession will stay with Union County. And a timeout's going to be called by David Tucker. Full timeout, we'll take it with him. You look at the huddle of David Tucker, he's not happy with 3:58. His Lady Panthers trail by 16. We'll be back in just a minute. First of four semifinals here on the Battle of the States Christmas Tournament. Union County and Hokes Bluff girls action. Next on the court will be Lumpkin County and Swain County. Ashley Fair will inbound it to Bailey Daniel, who almost double dribbled, and then a foul will end up being called on Gracie West. It's Gracie's first. Second team foul of the half. Hokes Bluff leading by 16 as Bailey Daniel drives in and gets her fourth points of the day. West up the floor now for Hokes Bluff. She gives it to Sydney Ball. Now Tylen Register. Register puts the ball on the floor and then gives to Sydney Ball. Ball driving in, kicks out to Gracie West. West back to Ball. Ball in the corner. She needs to get out of there and does, but then throws it into the backcourt. I thought it should have been backcourt. They don't call it. And then a lot of contact as Gracie West ran in to Brianna Hemphill, and then a three-pointer made by Union County. So that cuts the lead to 11 now. Up the floor, Gracie West. West driving with the right hand. She'll pull out to the corner, bounce pass to Sydney Ball, or rather, that's Logan Black, who was tripped by Ashley Fair. Amanda Noah going to check back into the game, so Hokes Bluff with their starters. A full timeout called by Union County. 2:47 to play. Union County has cut the Lady Eagle lead to 11. This game is nowhere near over yet, as we've seen some crazy games today on the girls' side. Again, Lumpkin County and Swain County. Lumpkin County trailed most of that game. Swain County kind of gave Lumpkin a chance to come back. Lumpkin playing great defense in the third and fourth quarters of play. Tied it up. Went down 4 points to start the overtime period before finishing on a 10-0 run to take the six-point win over Swain County. And then in the second consolation game for the girls, Polk and Piedmont. Piedmont led for most of that game. Polk County hits a layup, 2.6 seconds left in regulation, or in overtime rather. Piedmont off the timeout, gets the ball all the way down the floor with a wide open layup as time expires, but it's off the mark. So it'll be Lumpkin and Polk in the 1 o'clock game tomorrow. Swain and Piedmont in the 10 o'clock. Two overtime games in the girls' bracket already today. Could we be seeing a third? Union County trying to make a comeback. Johnson up, no good. Rebound pulled down by Adeline Dockery. Quickly up the floor, Bailey Daniel, bounce pass over. Ashley Fair for three is long. Trying to pull it down. It's going to be Union County basketball. 2.5 to play in the fourth. Inbound and blocked out of there. It'll stay with Union County. Inbounding is Ashley Fair. She gets it into Bailey Daniel. Daniel going to try and drive against Amanda Noah. The ball is going to end up coming out to Hemphill. Hemphill gives to Ashley Fair, who gives to Bailey Daniel. A lot of white jerseys standing close together. The green jerseys just able to play defense. Shot no good from Dockery. Offensive rebound taken away by Kendall Johnson, and Hokes Bluff content to work the ball up the floor slowly. We're under 2 minutes to play now. They get it across half court. Tylen Register throws the ball away. Bailey Daniel has to pull it out because she couldn't get up the floor quickly. And then Kendall Johnson almost comes up with it. Now Ashley Fair's got it. A lot of loose ball. Now Dockery driving in, puts up the shot. It's no good off the rim. Rebound tipped out of bounds by Union County. It'll be Lady Eagle basketball under 90 seconds to play now in regulation. Maddie Sutton checking in. Hokes Bluff working the ball up the floor. They find Amanda Noah on the other side of half court. Now Register down low to Johnson. One dribble, puts it off glass and in. Johnson with 13 points, and that might do it. It's a 13-point game, and we're under 70 seconds to play now. Union County's going to have to get hot. They've had trouble scoring all game as Kate McCarter will get to go to the line to shoot two off the foul from Johnson. Her 39-26 is the score. Substitution, Dockery out for younger sister Brooke Dockery. Shot up and good. McCarter cuts the lead to 12. Hokes Bluff gets it in. Tylen Register gets it across half court and gives to Black. Black drives, kicks out the ball. Ball to Black. Black back to ball. Union County trying to get a steal. It's a 12-point game. As Register gets it to ball and then gets it back. 37 seconds to play. She'll drive into the middle. Stop. Put it up through contact and will go to the line to shoot two. Foul will go on Maddie Sutton, her first. Register to the line to shoot two. She's got 10 points on the day. First free throw on its way is good. And there's the second. Union County gonna try and hurry up the floor. But I believe that it might be too little too late, as Union County is going to fall to Hokes Bluff in this one as the shot goes up for Maddie Sutton. It's no good. Amanda Noah pulls it down. And that might be it. Hokes Bluff gets it across half court. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, and that is the game. Your final score, Hokes Bluff will try and defend their championship tomorrow with a 41-27 win over Union County. Next game on the floor will be Lumpkin County and Swain County, and then Hayesville and Towns will have doubleheader action to round out the second day of the Battle of the States tournament.